फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। नाउ व्हाट आर द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टुडे? सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट एडिशन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एडिशन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन, इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ फ्रैक्शन। Let's start with addition of fractions. Now, addition of fractions are having two cases. Case number one, when two fractions are like fraction, and we're talking about the two fractions which are like. Like means the two fractions are having same denominator and numerators are different. Then what we have to do? Just add the numerators, only add the numerators and keep the denominator remain same. So let's see with an example. If 2 by 9 and 5 by 9 are two like fraction, since they are having 9 as common denominator, so what we have to do now, just keep 9 as a common denominator and add the two numerators 2 and 5, that will give you result, that is 7 upon 9. Similarly, in next example, 5 by 11 and 7 by 11. So 11 is a common and 5 by plus 7, that is equals to 12 upon 11. So this is the way how we are going to add two fractions with same denominator, or we can say that addition of two like fractions. Now addition of two fractions which are unlike. Now we are going to talk about the addition of two fractions which are unlike. Unlike means they are having different denominators. Like here you can see an example, 3 upon 10 and 8 upon 15, both are having a different denominators. So how we can add them? So what we have to do? Then first convert them in like fraction. So we have to do what? We have to convert them in like fraction, and then once they are converted into like fraction, then we have to follow case number one. Okay, so let's see how we can do. Suppose that 3 upon 10 and 8 upon 15 are two fractions, then what we have to do? We have to convert them into a like fraction. So how we can convert them in like fraction? Take the LCM of 10 and 15, that is your 30. Now we have to convert 3 upon 10 and 8 upon 15 into an equivalent fraction with same denominator, that is 30. So how we can convert? The first fraction is multiplied with 3 and the second fraction is multiplied with 2 to get this one. Now these two fractions are converted into their equivalent fraction with same denominator, that is 9 by 30 and 16 by 30. Now both are having same denominator, so they are converted into like fraction. So what we have to do now? Just add the numerators, 9 and 16, keeping denominator same, and you will get 25 upon 30. That is, count cancellation, you will get 5 upon 6. So this is your addition of two unlike fraction. Having a shortcut way also to add such unlike fractions. So how we can add them shortcut way? Suppose that this same number we are having, 3 upon 10 and that is this one. Now take the LCM of 10 and 15. Make the LCM a denominator and now divide 30 by 10, you will get 3, and this 3 is multiplied to the numerator of first, that is fraction, that is 3. So 3 3 is a 9 is here, and Again, 30 is divided by a second denominator 50, and this 2 is multiplied to the, that is, numerator of second fraction, so you will get a 16. So 16 is kept here. Now 9 and 16 are added to make it, that is, 25 upon 30. On cancellation, get 5 upon 6. Let's see with one more example. 13 upon 14 and plus 27 upon 35. Now take the LCM of, that is, 14 and 35, that is equals to 70. Now keep the LCM in denominator. Now see, 14 5s are 70. 14 5s are 70, so 5 is multiplied here in 13, so 13 5s are 65. Similarly, 35 2s are 70, so 2 is multiplied in 27, so you will get 27 into 2, that is 54. Now 65 and 54 are added, that will give you 119, and on cancellation with 7, you will get 17 upon 10, that is, and mixed fraction 1 whole 7 by 10. So this is the way when we can add to unlike fraction in a shortcut way. The properties of addition of fractions. Just like other numbers that we are talk about integers, they are also follow a certain laws. So addition of fraction is associative in nature, as well as it is commutative in nature. Associative means when we are having a three fractions, A by B, C by D and E by F, so we can add them in any order. So any two will be added first, then it should be added by the third one, and you will get the same result. Similarly, when we are having a two fraction, A by B plus C by D, and so we can add these two also in any order, either add A by B with C by D or C by D with A by B, the result will be same. So they will follow both associative and commutative law. So here we are not going to discuss much more about the properties of addition, this much only. You have to note that subtraction of fraction is neither commutative nor associative. So we are not going to discuss the property of subtraction also. Now how we can subtract two fractions. The subtraction of fraction can be performed in a manner similar to that of addition. So just like we are doing the addition, we have to perform subtraction also in the same manner. So we are again having got two cases. Case one, when two like fractions are there, so you have to just keep the that is denominator common. We can see here. Here and first example, that is 7 upon 9 and 5 upon 9, both are like fraction. So we have to just take 9 as a common denominator, and then 7 numerators are subtracted as per as the law of integers. So 7 minus 5, that is 2. So answer will be your 2 upon 9. Suppose that we are having the other two fractions which are not a like fraction, then what we have to do in the same manner. We are discussing about the shortcut method. Take the LCM of 16 and 12. The LCM will be your 48. Now 16 3s are 48. So we have to multiply 3 in 13. So 13 3s are 39. Then you have to keep minus sign. Then 12 4s are 48. So 4 should be multiplied to 7. So 7 4s are 28. Now 39 minus 28, that is 11. 11 upon 48 is the required answer. Similarly, take one more example, 11 upon 15 and 9 upon 20. So again, take the LCM of 15 and 20, you will get 60. Now keep 60 in denominator, and again 15 4s are 60, so 4 is multiplied with 11. So 11 4s are 44. Now put minus sign. 20 3s are 60. 9 3s are 27. Then 44 minus 27, that is 17 upon 60, and you will get the result that is 17 upon 16. Now let's discuss some important question which are based on this addition and subtraction. What should be added to 15 whole 2 by 3 to get 18 whole 5 by 6? So we have discussed such type of question in integers also. So what should be added? So we have to give the answer according to that only. Let x should be added to 15 whole 2 by 3. What should be added? X should be added to 15 whole 2 by 3 to get 18 5 by 6. Okay, now then x is equal, your mathematical expression becomes x plus 15 whole 2 by 3 is equals to 18 whole 5 by 6. Since we have to find out the value of x, so we have to say shift 15 whole 2 by 3 on the right side, so it becomes 18 5 by 6. Becomes 18 5 by 6 minus 15 whole 2 by 3. So now you have to subtract it. So first we have to convert it into a improper fraction. So when you convert this into improper fraction, so 18 into 6 then plus 5, that will gives you 113 upon 6, then 15 into 3 plus 2, that will gives you 47 upon 3. Now since these two are having a different denominators, and these are a unlike fraction, so we have to take the LCM of 6 and 3. So LCM of 6 and 3 is your 6. So now 6 1 ja 6, so 1 should be multiplied to 113, and 3 2 ja 6, so 2 is multiplied to 47, that will gives you 94. So 113 minus 94, that will give you 19 upon 6. In mixed it is 3 whole 1 by 6. So this is the way how we are going to solve this question. Now same, suppose that what should be subtracted from 17 whole 3 by 4 to get 11 whole 2 by 3. So again you have to write the same that is the expression. From a number which is written after from should be written first. So 17 whole 3 by 4 subtracted means minus. What should be subtracted? Let x be subtracted. So 17 whole 3 by 4 so 17 whole 3 by 4 minus x, that is equals to 11 whole 2 by, so this is the expression, that mathematical expression that you are going to make. Now we have to find out the value of x. Once we are going to find out the value of x, the value of x should be always positive. So we have to shift this x towards right side, so make it positive, and keep this, take this 11 2 by 3 this side. So it becomes a 17 3 by 4 minus 11 2 by 3. It becomes a 17 3 by 4 minus 11 2 by 3 on converting into a, that is a improper fraction. So what you have to do, 17 into 4 plus 3, that will gives you 71 upon 4, then minus again 11 into 3 plus 2, 35 upon 3. Now these two are again a unlike fractions, so take the LCM. LCM is your 12. LCM is your 12. Now 4 3s are 12, so 3 should be multiplied to 71. So it will gives you 213. 3 4s are 12, so 4 is multiplied to 35. That will gives you 140. 213 minus 140 will gives you 73 upon 12, and next it is 6 over 1 by 2. Okay, so this is the way how we are going to solve this. See one more question. Rohit ate 4/7 part of an apple and his sister Ritu ate the remaining part of it. So as we know that fraction is a part of whole. So if whole apple, the apple is taken as a whole, then 4/7 part, if we make a 7 equal parts of that apple, out of that 4 parts will be taken by Rohit. So how much part will be taken by her sister? That is 3 parts. 4 out of that 7 equal parts, 4 parts will be taken by Rohit. Then her sister will take up 3 part. So what will be the fraction for her sister Ritu? That is 3 by 7. Out of 7, she will take 3. Just like a Rohit take 4 out of 7. Similarly, Ritu will take 3 part out of 7. So we can make fraction, that is 3 upon 7. Or in mathematical way, if the part of Rohit will be 4 upon 7, then the remaining part will be, you have to subtract from the whole. The whole complete set will be 1. So out of that 1, if you subtract 4 upon 7, you will get a 3 upon 7. So this is also the way, but you can understand ki fraction is what? Fraction is describing about, that is the part of any whole thing. So if we take the whole apple and that whole apple is divided into 7 equal parts, and out of that 7 equal parts, the 4 parts are taken by Rohit, then the rest 3 parts taken by her sister Ritu. So what will be the fraction for Ritu? That is 3 upon 7. Okay, so simply we can find out 3 upon 7. Now it is very clear, out of 7 parts, since 4 parts are taken by Rohit and only 3 parts are taken by Ritu, obviously Rohit ate more. So 4 upon 7 is greater than 3 upon 7. It is clearly very common sense we can use. So now, how much the difference between them? Since Rohit ate 4 upon 7, Ritu ate 3 upon 7. So what will be the difference? You have to subtract 3 upon 7 from 4 upon 7 and you will get 1 upon 7. Obviously, but now see how we can calculate without using mathematics. Out of 7 parts, 4 taken by Rohit, 3 taken by Ritu. Obviously, Rohit takes 1 part more than that of Ritu. So, he takes 1 part more. So, what will be the fraction of that 1? That is 1 out of 7 he takes more. So, 1 upon 7 is your answer. So, this is the way how we can do the calculation without using mathematics. That is said to be a mental mathematics. Now, another one important question we are going to discuss. Suppose that Sarita bought 5 whole 3 by 4 kg of potatoes and 3 whole 1 by 2 kg of tomatoes from a vendor. Means 5 whole 3 by 4 kg potatoes and this much kg of tomatoes. So potatoes and tomatoes are purchased by, that is Sarita. So what will be the total weight of vegetables? Simply total weight means we have to add them. So before adding, we have to convert them into a improper fraction. So 5 into 4 plus 3, that is 23. Okay, so 23 upon 4 and 3, 2 just 6 plus 1, 7 upon 2, that is 7 upon 2 is a second fraction. Now, since these two fractions are not a like fraction, so we have to convert them into like fraction by taking LCM. So, LCM will be your 4. Now, 4, 1 ja 4, so 1 is multiplied to 23, so you have 23 only. 2, 2 ja 4, 2 is multiplied to 7, so 7, 2 ja 14. Now, 23 plus 14, that will give you 37. So the total weight will be 37 upon 4 kg, or we can say that 9 whole 1 by 4 kg. So this is the way how we are going to solve the word problems related to addition and subtraction. We are going to end our session here only. So in next topic, we will discuss about the multiplication of fraction. Till you have to complete your exercise 2A in homework, and you have to make your separate copies now. You have to make your notes. You have to solve your exercises very neatly, very clearly. All the solutions are provided to you. Okay, so don't say that sir, ye nahi aaya, wo nahi aaya, aisa nahi tha, waisa nahi tha. If your copies are not completed after when the schools will be reopened, your marks will be deducted from your, that is whatever the marks will be given by your teacher for the your assessments. Okay, so and if you are having any doubts related with these exercise 2A or any other part that is explained in your videos, so you can ask in your WhatsApp group just between 12 noon to 1 p.m. Okay, be safe, stay at home. Thank you.